Hello everybody, in this video I will solve the LAP from Chapter 3 CCNA 7 Introduction to Networks course, and this LAP is about using Wireshark to sniff the packets in the network. The name of this LAP is Use Wireshark to View Network Traffic. I will not use this topology in this video, but I will use my own PC as one device, and the second device will be my smart tablet, and both of them are connecting to the router by Wi-Fi. So what is Wireshark? Wireshark is a network tool that is used to examine the packets in the network, as you will see in this video how we will do this. So let's jump and start to read the objectives. What are the objectives from this lab? In part 1, capture and analyze local ICMP data in Wireshark, and then in part 2, capture and analyze remote ICMP data in Wireshark. So first we will use our own local network, represented by the two, the PC and the smart device, and then we will start to check the ICMP in a remote network. Let's read the background or the scenario. Wireshark is a software protocol analyzer or packet sniffer application used for network troubleshooting, analyzes, software and protocol development and education. As data streams travel back and forth over the network, the sniffer captures each protocol data unit, PDU, and can decode and analyze its content according to the appropriate request for comment RFC or other specifications. Wireshark is a useful tool for anyone working with networks and can be used with most labs in the CCNA courses for data analysis and troubleshooting. In this lab, you will use Wireshark to capture ICMP data packet IP addresses and Ethernet frame MAC addresses. What is required? Required one PC and an additional PC on a local network. And as I said, here I will use my PC and my smart tablet. Using a packet sniffer such as a Wireshark may be considered a breach of the security policy of the school. It's recommended that permission to be obtained before running Wireshark for this lab. If using a packet sniffer such as Wireshark is an issue, the instructor may wish to assign the lab as a homework or perform a walkthrough demonstration. Okay, we finished now the objectives and the scenario and what is required. So let's start with the instructions. Capture part 1, we capture and analyze local ICMP data in Wireshark. So we will use the local network. In part 1 of this lab, you will ping another PC. In this case, I will ping my smart device on the LAN and capture ICMP requests and replies in Wireshark. You will also look inside the frames captured for specific information. The analysis should help to clarify how packet headers are used to transport data to their destination. Okay, so step 1, retrieve your PC interface addresses. For this lab, you will need to retrieve your PC IP addresses and its network interface card and IC physical address. So I need to know my current IP address and my current MAC address, also called the MAC address. In a command prompt window, so in the CMD, we have to type ipconfig/all. And as I said, I'm connecting to the network using Wi-Fi, so I'm searching for the Wi-Fi adapter. And as you can see here, this is my IP address. And this is my subnet mask. And the default gateway is this one. This is the IP address of the ports inside the router, or this is the IP address of the router. And this is my MAC address. Okay. So ask the team member or the team members of their PC IP addresses and provide your PC IP address to them. Do not provide them your MAC address at this time. So as I said, I will use the IP address of my smart device. Okay, so start Wireshark and begin capturing data. So here, this is the Wireshark GUI interface, and I'm using Wi-Fi. So we double click on the Wi-Fi and we can start sniffing the data. And in step two, navigate to Wireshark, double click on the desired interface to start the packet capture. We already did that. Make sure that the desired interface has traffic. Yes, we can see here the traffic. B, information will start scrolling down the top screen of the Wireshark. Yes, we saw that. The data lines will appear in different colors based on protocol. Yes, we can see here, we can see red, black, gray, blue, yellow, and others. This information can scroll by very quickly depending on what communication is taking place between your PC and the LAN. We can apply a filter to make it easier to view and work with the data that is being captured by Wireshark. For this lab, we are only interested in displaying ICMP, the Bing protocol data unit. Type ICMP in the filter box at the top of the Wireshark and press enter, or click apply button arrow assigned to view only ICMP ping PDU. Okay, let's do that. Here we need only to filter traffic to search only ICMP, and then we can click here this button, or we can press enter. And as you can see here, we are filtering only the ICMP protocols. And okay, this filter causes all data in the top window to disappear, but you still capture the traffic on the interface. Navigate to the command prompt window and ping the IP address of that you received from a team member. So we will go here and we will ping the IP address of my smart device, and the IP address of the smart device is 192.168.0.103. And as you can see here, it is pretty much the network portion from this IP address is the same of my PC because it's in the local network. And then let's press enter. And you can see here something is happening, or something is happening right now. Let's see what is here. And we have the same color in the from the lab, and both of them are pink. So let's see what is happening. Notice that you starting seeing data appear in the top window of Wireshark again. Yes. So there is also a note if you cannot see the ping, or the ping, the pings don't work or unsuccessfully returned. It means that it may happen that you have the firewall on your on the PC of your team member. So if it's not working, so you can check the firewall and stop cap. Then stop capturing data by clicking on the stop capture, and you can see here this is that red square. You can stop capture. Okay, so in step three, examine the captured data. In step three, examine the data that was generated by the ping request of your team member PC. Wireshark data is displayed in three sections. So this is section number one. Here you can see section number two. And we still miss section in part 3. In step 3, examine the data that was generated by ping request on your team member. PC Wireshark data is displayed in the three sections. So we have three sections. The top section, this is the first, the section number one. It displays the list of the protocol data units frames captured with a summary of the IP packet information listed. Two, the middle section lists protocol data unit information for the frame selected in the top part and of the screen and separates a captured protocol data unit frame by its protocol layers. And three, the bottom section displays the raw data of each layer. The raw data is displayed in both hexadecimal and decimal form. So let's see, this is, we have section one and it displays the packets, and in, let's assume we can select this packet, and here in section 2, and this is the second section, it displays the information related to the packet that has been selected from section 1, and the third section, this is the raw data, it can be in decimal or in hexadecimal. Okay, so click on the first ICMP request frame in the top section of the Wireshark. Notice that the source column has your PC IP address and the destination column contains the IP address of the teammate PC that you are ping. So in the first request, and we can see here the source is the, this is my IP address of my PC and this is the IP address of the smart device that I am pinging it. Okay. So with the protocol data unit frame still selected in the top section, navigate to the middle section, click the plus sign to the left of the Ethernet to row to view the destination and the source MAC address. So this is the Ethernet, and you can see here, this is the destination MAC address. This is here, and it's the name of it is Samsung. And this is the source, this is the MAC address of my PC that we already saw it in the beginning when I typed ibconfig/all. Okay, so here is that we have some questions. Does the source MAC address match your PC? Yes, we saw that. Does the destination MAC address in Wireshark match your team member MAC address? Yes, it is. It does. How is the MAC address of the binged PC obtained by your PC? So to answer this question, we have to think about the address resolution protocol. When the MAC address is obtained through the address resolution protocol request, and we have also a note here in the preceding example of the capture ICMP request, ICMP data is encapsulated inside an IP version 4 packet protocol data unit IP version 4 header, which is then encapsulated in the Ethernet 2 frame protocol data unit Ethernet for transmission on the LAN. Okay, it was the end of part 1. Now we will move forward to part 2. In part 2, we will try to use ICMP ping in Wireshark for a remote network. So here in part 2, you will ping a remote host on another LAN and examine the generated data from those pings. You will then determine what is the difference about this data from the data examined in part 1. We start the capturing data of the interface, start the capture again. So we will start again and we will have a message here. So in this case, we don't need to save the previous one. We will continue without saving. And now, with the capture active being the following three websites. So we will bing first the Yahoo, bing www.yahoo.com. Yes. And then we will bing Cisco.com. Cisco.com. Also, it is okay. And then finally, we will bing Google.com. We need to type the command ping, and it's also successfully finished. And now we, when you ping the URL listed, notice that the domain DNS translated the URL to the IP address, and note the IP address received from each URL. You can now stop the capture data by clicking the stop capture. So we will stop, and let's examine and analyzing the data from the remote host. Review the captured data in Wireshark and examine the IP and the MAC addresses of the three locations that you pinged. List the destination IP and MAC address for all the three locations in the space provided. So first, let's check the Yahoo. Okay, so this is for Yahoo. And where is the IP address for Yahoo? The IP address is this one, as you can see here. And the MAC address for Yahoo, we will move here and we can see the MAC address of yahoo.com. And as you can see here, we can see four packets, 1, 2, 3, 4. So request and reply, request and reply, request and reply. And again, request and reply for the each of them. So for Yahoo, we have request and we have reply. We have request and reply for the second packet. We have request and reply for the third packet. And we have request and reply for the fourth packet. So as you and you can see here, it's about yahoo.com. Now let's move to the Google. We finished, sorry, the second one was cisco.com. So this is the what is the IP address for cisco.com, and you can see here this is the IP address of the cisco.com, and what is the MAC address for cisco.com? It is this one listed here, and it is the destination. Again, we have request, we have reply. This is for packet one, request and reply for packet two, request and reply for third one, and request and reply for the fourth one. Then we will move forward to the last one, which was google.com. And again, the IP address, what was the IP address for the okay, which is significant about this information? So the most important thing that is significant about this information is the MAC address. All of the three devices are the same, if you notice that. And how does this information differ from the local Bing information you received in part one? So in part one, the MAC address that we received, it was the MAC address of my smart tablet. It was Samsung, but here the MAC address of the destination device was the same, and it was the MAC address of the default gateway, and in this case it was the MAC address of the router that I'm connecting currently on it, and it is type of D-Link. This is the end of this video. Please try to run it again on your machine, and you can work with your classmate from the lab.